Hello friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan. I am happy to meet you through the video lecture series on the subject hidden mass transfer. And we are discussing module 5, radiation heat transfer. This is lecture number 13. Here again we are going to solve problems on the radiation between three surface enclosure. And we recap from the previous lectures. We discussed the theory for radiation between three surface enclosure, and we discussed the re-radiating surface. Also, we solved a few problems in the previous lectures. And here again, we are going to solve problems, additional problems on the radiation between three surface enclosure. And at the end of this lecture, you will be able to solve problems on your own on this topic, radiation between three surface enclosure. And we take the example number 31. A furnace is shaped like a long equilateral triangular duct as shown in the figure. The width of each side is 1 meter. The base of the base surface has emissivity of 0.7 and is maintained at a uniform temperature of 600 Kelvin. The heated left side surface closely approximate a black body at 1000 Kelvin. The right side surface is well insulated. Determine the rate at which heat must be supplied to the heated side externally per unit length of the duct in order to maintain these operating conditions. So this is the question from the university question paper AU May 2019. And given data, the side of the triangle base, all the three sides are equal to 1 meter. Temperature of the surface 1 is 600 Kelvin. Temperature of the surface 2 is 1000 Kelvin, which is considered as a black surface. And third surface is insulated. And the emissivity of the first surface is 0.7, and this is black surface emissivity equal to 1. So resistance equal to 0. So for the second surface, there is no safe factor surface resistance, and third surface is insulated. This is acting as a re-radiating surface, so there is no surface resistance. For second surface and third surface, there is no surface resistance, and this is the network arrangement for the network diagram for the arrangement. So the first surface is the base surface, which has the emissive power EB1 and the surface resistance R1 and radiosity J1. The surface 2 is a black surface, so there is no resistance, surface resistance, so J2 equal to EB2. And the surface 3 is re-radiating and insulated, which is re-radiating, and J3 is also equal to EB3. And the area of the surface, we take the equal sides of 1 meter. So the length is considered as unit length, so area equal to 1 meter. And the surface resistance of the first surface R1 equal to 1 minus epsilon 1 by A1 epsilon 1, which is 1 minus 0.7 divided by 1 into 0.7 equal to 0.43. 0.43. And the shape factor for a triangular surface, F12, this is equal to A1 plus A2 minus A3 divided by 2A1. So this is surface 1, this is surface 1, this side is A1, this side is A2, and this side is A3. So using this equation, we can calculate A1 plus A2 minus A3 divided by 2A1 equal to 0.5. And the F13 equal to F23 equal to 1 minus F12 equal to 0.5. So the shape factor between 1 and 2 is 0.5, 1 and 3 and 2 and 3 equal to 0.5. And the shape factor resistances, R12 equal to 1 by A1, F12 equal to 1 by 1 into 0.5 equal to 2, and similarly R23 is also 1 by A1 F13 equal to 1 by 0.1 into 0.5 equal to 2. And for the circuit arrangement, we have to calculate the equivalent resistance. So this is R1, and these three resistances, they give the equivalent resistance. So the equivalent resistance of R1, R13 and R23, it is calculated like this. So equivalent resistance equal to 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by R12 plus 1 by R13 plus R23. Substituting the values, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 2 equal to 0.75, and the equivalent resistance equal to 1.33. Now the heat transfer between surface 1 and 2, this is sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by R1 plus R equivalent. So, substituting 5.61 10 power minus 8 into 700 to the power 4 minus 1000 to the power 4 divided by 0.43 plus 1.33 equal to minus 24.48 kilowatts. So, the minus sign significance or negative sign is the heat is transferred from the heat is given to the second surface. That is, heat surface 2 is at a higher temperature, the heat is transferred to the to the second surface, which is at 1000 Kelvin, and this is the amount of heat to be supplied to the hot plate to maintain the operating condition. So rate of heat supply required to the hot plate is 24.48 kilowatts. And we take another example, example number 32. So here there are two 60 centimeter by 60 centimeter plate are perpendicular to with the common edge are placed in a large room at 30 degrees Celsius. One plate is maintained at 600 Kelvin with the emissivity of 0.65. The other plate is insulated. Calculate the temperature of the insulated plate and the heat loss by the plate which is at 600 Kelvin. So there are three plates. Two plates are with the common edge. First plate, which is at a temperature of 600 Kelvin with the emissivity 0.65. Second plate is insulated. And the third is the room, which is at temperature of 30 degrees Celsius, which is 303 Kelvin. Now here again, the second plate is insulated and third is the room, which is re-radiating. So for the 2 and the 3, there is no surface resistance and this is the network diagram. So EB1, R1, EB1 is the emissive power of the first surface, J1 is the radiosity of the first surface, R1 is the surface resistance, R12 is the shape factor resistance and R13, R23 are the shape factor resistances. So J3 equal to EB3, J2 equal to EB2. Now area of the plate A1 equal to A2 equal to 0.6 into 0.6 equal to 0.36 meter square. Now here we have to calculate the shape factor for the arrangement. And so X, Y, Z, all the values are equal to 6.6. So X equal to Y equal to Z equal to 0.6. So we have to calculate the capital Y, which is small y divided by X equal to 0.6 by 0.6 equal to 1. And the capital Z equal to small Z by small X equal to 0.6 by 0.6 equal to 1. So X, Z by X equal to 1, and this is also, the Y by X is also 1, and the shape factor is F12 equal to 0.12. So from this diagram, you can find out the shape factor for the arrangement, which is 0.2. And the surface resistance, R1 equal to 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 epsilon 1 equal to 1 minus 0.65 divided by 0.36 into 0.65 equal to 1.5. And the shape factor, what we calculated earlier, F12 equal to 0.2, F12 equal to F23 equal to 1 minus F12 equal to 1 minus 0.2 equal to 0.8, and the shape factor resistances R12 equal to 1 by A1 F12, which is equal to 1 by 0.36 into 0.2 equal to 13.9, and R13 equal to R23 equal to 1 by A1 F13 equal to 1 by 0.36 into 0.8 equal to 3.47. And the equivalent resistance, as in the previous case, the equivalent resistance is 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by R12 plus 1 by R13 plus R23, substituting 1 by 13.9 plus 1 by 3.47 plus 3.47 equal to 0.216. So R equivalent equal to 4.63. Now the heat transfer between the surface 1 and the room 3, so Q equal to sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus T3 to the power 4 divided by R1 into R1 plus R equivalent, which is 5.67 into 10 power minus 8 into 600 to the power 4 minus 300 to the power 4 divided by 1.5 plus 4.67 equal to 1120.8 watts. Now the value of node J1, because the from the Q value we can calculate J1 equal to EB1 minus QR1, which is 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 600 to the power 4, this minus 1120.8 into 1.5 is equal to 5667.12 watts. Now Kirchhoff's law for the J2, node J2, we can write J1 minus J2 would be R12 plus J3 minus J2 equal to R23, and J1 value we have calculated here 5667.12 minus J2 divided by R12 equal to 13.9 plus J3 equal to EB3, which is 5.61 10 power minus 8 into 303 to the power 4 minus J2 divided by 3.47, and solving this equation numerically, we get J2 equal to 1514.2 watts per meter square. So J2 value is 1514.2 watts per meter square. And temperature of the insulated plate, J2 equal to EB2 equal to sigma T2 to the power 4. So 1514.2 514.2 equal to 5.67 10 power minus 8 into T2 to the power 4. And solving this equation, the temperature of the insulated plate equal to 404.25 Kelvin. The answers are, temperature of the insulated plate is 404.25 Kelvin, and the heat loss by the plate, which is at 600 Kelvin, equal to 1120.8 watts per meter square. So all the calculations are per meter square area. So we stop here. So these are all the books I referred for the problem and the theory of the subject. You can also refer to it. And this is the book what I have published earlier. You can reach to it for your further study or further information. And you can write to me my mail ID for any queries, and I will answer all your queries. So thank you. We'll meet again.